I made it 2 years ago, and it's going to be touring this year.
How did you find yourself looking at Pretty Ugly videos? What began this project?
I was doing a lot of research at the time. It was like 2012. I was doing loads of research into how teenage girls were using the internet, and I got like totally obsessed with how they were using Tumblr and like strange sort of online communities like inspiration sites and things like that. And that was part of like my research into femininity and masochism, because that's kind of my source of machism. And it was one day when I was on one of those inspiration sites on Tumblr that I saw this video of like a really young girl. She must have been like, I don't know, 10 or something, and she was like looking really earnestly into the camera and saying, you know, what do you think about me like this? And she was sort of pouting, and then she was saying like, the boys don't like me at school, I don't know why. And then she asked whether she was pretty or ugly, and I just was like horrified by it. And then I saw that there were like literally 500,000 other videos exactly the same like that, girls like 8 to 13, and I just thought, I've got to make a short video.
The reaction you're looking for, is it more kind of like from an activist point of view?
This is probably my most like feminist statement, and I think, like, I don't know, I guess I want to take the audience on like a journey of my research, what happened to me. I'm not trying to like teach anyone anything. It's more like, look at this, look how strange it is, and I guess through that I kind of reveal my sort of stance on it. The thing for me about this subject matter was that I found all these videos online, but there wasn't any like discussion about it, and so I really hoped that bringing this to light and bringing it to audiences all around the UK and hopefully Europe, it could sort of start to oil some discussions around it.
The target audience are kind of getting at, it's probably not the people that are seeing.
Yeah, that's the really hard thing about the show, is that it's about an age group that it's not appropriate for.
Yeah.
So that's really, really hard. Like, one of the things when I talk to people about, when they ask me like, oh, what can we do about this? And I think like it's totally all about education, and it is about their age group, but it's also about our age group and their parents' age group, and teaching them that this stuff is happening. And I think that's the really weird thing about this current like generation of that age group that are growing up. They're called like the digital natives, and I feel like it's really weird because they are actually so much more savvy than we are with like technology and the internet. And it's that weird thing of like, how do you teach them when they know way more than us? That, you know, they're always going to have access to those kind of sites and stuff. So yeah, I think it's almost a matter of like us catching up with them, really.
So you're going on tour, hopefully.
Yes.
Are you planning to develop this further, the show itself?
No, it's finished.
Okay.
It's finished. Yeah, I had like a really long development period of it. And now I'm just really happy for it to be done. And yeah, so the plan is that this year I'm going to tour it around the UK, and I'm going to be doing workshops alongside it for teenagers as well.
Do you have any plans for future shows yet, or are you considering on touring?
No, I am starting to develop a new show as well, which is kind of like a departure from this show in that it's still kind of the same subject area, but it's going to be more about like online porn. And women and violence.
Okay, cool. So next year, buzzcut, that'll be
yeah.